If you're a subscriber of mine, you've probably already seen the video that I made on Philip Broberg, where I took a look and gave my honest opinions on the young Swedish defenseman, talked about what I like, what I didn't like, and whether or not I believe he is a top NHL prospect in this year's draft. With that being established, though, he's not necessarily someone that I would think I would want for the Vancouver Canucks, my favorite NHL team. So, let's talk about Philip Broberg and what he would do with the Montreal Canadiens instead. Probably my second favorite team in the league. I think I like the Habs more than the Leafs now, so there's my second, I'm pretty sure. But let's talk about Broberg because he is a guy who might be available at 15th overall when the Habs draft, and I know every time I make a video on who the Habs should select in this year's draft, the guy that always comes up in the comments from all you Habs fans over there is Philip Broberg. Broberg is a guy who I've already made a video about, so if you wanted to check that out, you could totally do that. It's probably on the side somewhere, or it'll be in the description. But Philip Broberg, in my opinion, is probably the one defenseman aside Bowen Byram who, in my opinion, has a legitimate shot at being a number one top two D-man. His game is driven by speed 100%, and his great skating allows him to execute at a high level. It's just that his decision-making and everything else around that needs a whole lot of work if he wants to take the next step into the NHL. But you can't ignore the fact that the potential is there. Out of everybody in this draft, Bowen Byram, Soderstrom, Heinola, and Broberg, it's probably only Byram and Broberg who have top two potential. Byram has a lot more capacity, and he will most likely reach that potential. Broberg, it's 50-50. I can see it going either way. But for the Montreal Canadiens, drafting at number 15, they could certainly use a left-handed defenseman, and that's kind of what Habs fans have been clamoring for quite a few months now. People are talking about, hey, we need left-handed defensemen, defense, we got the right-handed guy in Weber, we need more defense on the left side, and Broberg brings exactly that. If he maxes out to his best potential, he's a guy who could probably put up 50-60 points as a top 2 defender at an elite level, and somebody who can drive the play, score some nifty goals, set up some great guys with speed and quick passes. Doesn't that sound like somebody the Montreal Canadiens could use? Having this guy quarterbacking a power play with Nick Suzuki, Kotkaniemi, Paling, and I don't know, Yolonen or whatever, that would be amazing. Having Broberg as the number one offensive dynamo on the blue line, he could really provide a new layer to this Montreal Canadiens team and allow some of these guys to really play the game quickly. Because Broberg, he's built around speed. His game lives through speed. Speed is his game. And sure, he has to work on a lot of other things, decision-making, defensive capabilities, and overall compete level, but Broberg has a ceiling, and it's very high. It's just that the floor is quite low, too. I made this point in my Broberg video, and I think I'm going to say it again here. Broberg is a guy who will make the NHL just because he is so good at skating alone. But everything around that, him being able to make the right decisions, make the smart play, and not kind of act like a mosquito out there in the ice, just rushing around with no real purpose. If he can do all of those things, he's got the utmost potential to be a top two guy, and it really depends on the team that drafts him and their coaching abilities in being able to coach the bad out of Broberg while keeping the fantastic speed-based game too. Because we've seen it, Broberg is extremely talented. It's just that there's a reason he's not getting that many points in the Allsvenskan. There's a reason he's dropping down the draft rankings. It's because he's such a raw talent and he needs a lot of refinement. Whether that be in Sweden or in the NHL or the AHL, he needs the coaching to really work him into a great number one. And whether or not the Montreal Canadiens are the team to do that, that's up to them, but I will say here that if that does happen, and if Montreal does coach him correctly, and he does develop into a number one, that's exactly what the Montreal Canadiens are going to get. A number one defenseman who can really help out Suzuki. Suzuki's gotten faster, by the way. I don't know if you've seen all of the Guelph Storm games, but Suzuki is way faster than when he was acquired in that Pacioretty trade a year ago. Suzuki is better, Paling is here, he's a powerhouse, and we got other fast guys too. I didn't even mention Gallagher, Domi, and Drouin. all of these guys can really benefit from having a solid number one defenseman on the back end whose game is built on speed. And that's kind of the whole NHL nowadays, isn't it? It's all speed-based. Guys don't need to be big anymore. You can have small, shifty, quick guys. As long as they know how to play, they can play. And Broberg, even though he isn't small, he's certainly not small, I'm not trying to say that, he's a guy who's got the whole package as a number one offensive defenseman if he's able to develop that way. Because when it comes to skaters in the draft, Broberg is top three? Top two? Jack Hughes is the best skater in the draft. I think Newhook or Broberg come in second. You can make an argument for either one of those guys, but the fact is that both of them will probably be available when the Montreal Canadiens draft at 15. Who knows, maybe Newhook gets taken 11th or 10th or whatever, but Broberg is probably going to be there. I don't see Broberg jumping up a little bit higher than the Cousins, the Docks, the USNTDP guys, so having him available at 15 does seem like a likely scenario. And this is what I think he will do with the Montreal Canadiens if they develop him right. Hope you enjoyed this video. Social media, gaming, and bye.